In this video, I'm going to present some of the resources that were most helpful for me when I self-studied multivariable calculus. First, we'll cover an important distinction between a computational and a theoretical multivariable calculus course. Next, we'll go over the resources that were useful for me from MIT to Khan Academy, Herbert Gross, Professor Leonard, and Paul's online math notes. All links will be in the description. If you've watched my video with resources on linear algebra, then you'll know that linear algebra also has this distinction between a computational course and a theoretical course. And I want to start by saying that this distinction is actually more blurred in multivariable calculus because the topics really are the same, it's just the perspective that's different. So computational is going to, in general, stick to two and three dimensions, and as the name suggests, you're going to mostly be computing things. You're going to be calculating derivatives, integrals, limits, all the good stuff. Theoretical courses are going to be proof-based, and you're going to be working, instead of in two and three dimensions, in n dimensions when possible. So you're going to be doing limits, derivatives, and integrals in n dimensions, and because of this, a little bit of exposure to linear algebra is helpful. So in general, if you have seen linear algebra before, then theoretical is a great option for you. Both courses are covering similar content, and this is even more so than in linear algebra, where there's a slightly greater divergence between theoretical and computational courses. And it's important to remember that no course is better than the other course, they're just different. If you want to take a computational course in multivariable calculus, then MIT 18.02 Scholar is a cornerstone resource for your studies. The Scholar means that MIT has put extra effort into making this online course as valuable as possible for independent learners like you. This course includes lectures, which are these recorded lectures from MIT professors and also from recitations, in addition to lecture notes for each lecture. It has problem sets and solutions, so you can check your answers. And it also has exams with solutions, in addition to practice exams. Unfortunately, there's no built-in schedule, but I might suggest one problem set per week. There's no textbook required for this course because they consider it to be self-contained, which means you don't have to buy a textbook, so that's wonderful. If you want to take a theoretical course in multivariable calculus, I would recommend MIT's 18.024. This is actually the course I did when I took my multivariable calculus as a self-study. This is a theoretical course, which means that the emphasis is on proof. There are no recorded lectures, but there are supplementary notes written by Emeritus Professor at MIT, James Munkris. And the problem sets have solutions, which is great. The exams also have solutions. This is a good source of practice, and there is a schedule for when you can be doing these. Again, one problem set per week is fairly reasonable. The textbook is Calculus Volume 2 by Tom M. Apostle, and this textbook is well written. There's not too much to say. It covers everything. You can see that I've called the MIT courses the backbone of your studies, and they really are. These are where you're going to find your textbook and your homework. So they're forming the foundation of everything that you're going to be doing. But nonetheless, it can be good to have some supplementary resources to fill in the gaps where the textbook might be presenting something in a confusing way, or to find additional practice or different perspectives. So in the next part of this video, we're going to go over good supplemental resources. And the first of these is, of course, Khan Academy. Khan Academy's videos on multivariable calculus are a collaboration between Sal Khan and Grant Sanderson from the math YouTube channel 3 Blue 1 Brown. The videos are 5 to 20 minutes long in the classic Khan Academy style. These videos cover all of computational multivariable calculus, and while there are some proofs, especially for the later theorems in the course, these are not emphasized, so if you're doing a theoretical multivariable calculus course, you won't get proofs from Khan Academy. But nonetheless, regardless of which course you're doing, Khan Academy's videos are helpful because you get good explanations of the concepts, and like I said earlier, the concepts don't differ quite as much between computational and theoretical. It really is the proofs in the amount of dimensions that you're doing it in. But what Khan Academy can be especially good for, and that's particularly the case because Grant Sanderson is helping, is giving you intuition. Grant Sanderson's YouTube channel, 3Blue1Brown, has absolutely stunning visuals, and if you take Khan Academy's course, you'll actually see some of the precursors to the software that he uses on his own channel, for example, the image on the bottom right, he was developing this software while he was a content fellow at Khan Academy. So you'll get really strong sense of intuition that you can carry with you even as you maybe read your proof-based textbook if you're doing a theoretical course. And they're also very useful for brushing up on any specific concepts that you might be struggling on from your textbook. Another great supplementary resource is Herbert Gross's MIT lectures that were released in 1972. Now, recording these in 1972, he had to do these 30 to 40 minute videos all in one take. This man is a superhero. Now, there are 26 lectures in the multivariable calculus course that he made, and there is an emphasis on examples. So he would pre-write everything on the board, and he's able to talk instead of writing more, whereas Khan Academy is often the person writing. So it's a more fast-paced video, and he's able to talk about the intuition behind what's going on the board. So these lectures are really good for teaching you. But beyond that, Herbert Gross also provides study materials. So this is practice problems and supplemental readings if you want to go beyond the lectures. He also provides solutions to practice problems. So this is a great way to find additional practice for topics you might be struggling on in multivariable calculus. Now, if Herbert Gross is a superhero, then Professor Leonard is Superman. I mean, look at those muscles. Professor Leonard on his YouTube channel has about 30 lectures from the multivariable calculus class that he taught at the college where he is a professor. And each lecture is about 2 to 3 hours long because he combines several classes to form a comprehensive video that covers everything about one topic. And the reason the videos are so long is that he uses many examples. As you can see on the image, he is in the process of going through an in-depth example. Professor Leonard is an absolutely wonderful resource for going over a concept that you are not sure about, and you just need to see a lot of examples of how it's used correctly so that you can start applying it when you do practice and homework. So there's less emphasis on proofs in Professor Leonard's videos, but he just uses so many examples. It is a gold mine of a resource if that is what you need. And finally, if you thought that Professor Leonard was a gold mine, look at Paul's online math notes. Now, Paul's online math notes has many more courses than just multivariable calculus, but that's what we're going to talk about here. It's a website with specific pages dedicated to each topic in multivariable calculus, so it's essentially an online textbook. Paul's online math notes has a vast number of examples to show how concepts work in action. It also has exposition that will actually teach you the concepts. It has graphics so that it's visual, and it has lots and lots of practice. So Paul's online math notes is really flexible. Whatever you need, you can go to the page on the topic in multivariable calculus. I mean, you could read this thing through from start to end to learn multivariable calculus, or you could go to a specific topic that you need help with. Whatever you need, Paul's online math notes probably has it covered. I tried to include in this video the resources that were most critical for me when I was learning multivariable calculus, and I think that you could go far using just these resources, but it is definitely not exhaustive. So as you learn multivariable calculus on your own, I'd recommend that you keep your eyes peeled for new videos, new websites, anything that will help you learn. Make this self-study your own and have fun with it. And if you haven't already, I'd recommend that you watch my video on self-study strategies for math so that you can take all these resources that you now have for learning multivariable calculus and you can turn them into a really successful self-study by getting your self-study mindset in a good place and by going over some philosophies of self-study and tips like how to organize your self-study. So with that said, good luck. I hope you really enjoy your multivariable calculus self-study.